One of the most fascinating and novel things surrounding Ridley Scott's Alien prequels have been the digital shorts that found releases on YouTube for anyone to view or as part of the special features for the film's home video releases. I say they're novel because that's really what they are, a novelty, supplemental, optional really. While these shorts fill certain gaps, enhance certain things about certain characters, generally give us more information, they're not necessary to enjoy or understand the standalone films themselves. Maybe some would disagree with that, but I personally don't feel that something such as the Wayland TED Talk or the Crossing prologue would have impacted the overall movies had they been included in the openings of their respective films. Other shorts such as the Prometheus Transmission, Quiet Eye, Meet Walter, The Last Supper, and Advent, to name a few of these, all add just a little bit more with immersion into the universe and some context in the timeline. And watching these may even get you to consider the events of the films from a different angle and offer just a little bit more for the experience. As a fan of the films, the extended universe, and overall enthusiast of minutiae, I think it's great to be able to throw on the DVD or digital copy or visit the Alien YouTube channels and be able to watch stuff like this. Covenant in particular went to such unheard of extremes with its digital marketing. There'd been so much content preceding and following the film's release that I really am in awe of how much they got in the can, as they say, in addition to the actual film. I would hope that, even if you don't personally like the films, you could appreciate that this kind of stuff is available for those that do. So, wouldn't you know it, it's a good full 2 years after Alien Covenant's home video release and we are still seeing these digital shorts. I think that's pretty cool. So, when I saw that in commemoration of the 2 year anniversary a new short was released, I of course had to give it a look. The short's title is David's Lab, Last Signs of Life, which I hope the title isn't a reference to the state of the franchise and just a coincidence, but who knows. This is a collaboration with YouTube Space LA, a production facility specifically tailored for YouTube projects, obviously not part of the original promotional media for Covenant, but something done after the fact using the excellent David's Lab sets and props. More accurately, it looks like the props are straight from the film, but the set is a recreation. With that in mind, I wasn't expecting Michael Fassbender to pop up as David or anything like that, but at the very least I had a good feeling we'd get some good money shots of the location and all the creepy crawlies which inhabit it. I can confidently say they delivered on that aspect. It's not especially involved otherwise, more of a tour of sorts through the mad android's lab. There's not too much to spoil here, but I'll give a spoiler warning nevertheless, so if you're interested in checking it out yourself, I'll leave a link below. Spoilers moving forward, though. This short takes place after the events of Alien Covenant, with a lone Weyland-Yutani salvager exploring David's now-abandoned lab on the mysterious and elusive Planet 4. You may recall from another Covenant-related short, also related to David's experiments, Alien Advent, that David had sent a transmission to the company with his findings. He described this transmission and the information within as an olive branch. He wanted others to know his secret, and it seems he wanted his lab and the remaining specimens to be found by Weyland-Yutani, and this would be the follow-up. Whether this poor soul is absolutely alone or has a crew along with him, with a ship waiting, can't be said for sure, but I'm willing to bet there were others, ready to unknowingly bring a specimen back aboard their vessel. He takes a look around, we see all the horrors and classifications on the helmet's display, and, as you can expect, he encounters a xenomorph egg, and, at the end, he is face-hugged. A predictable enough end for the short, nothing especially groundbreaking or mind-blowing here, but, as it's put in their description of the video, it's a little fun. And it is. I always thought this was a great set and location for the movie. It really evokes the feel of a mad scientist lab from the great classic monster movies, but with its own alien edge, and for Covenant, it was one of the most interesting aspects for me. It seemed like the gift that kept on giving, too. Prior to Covenant's release, and quite a bit after, there'd always be some neat behind-the-scenes pictures or footage of the set. And as we kept seeing more, we could get a better sense of David's years of obsession beyond just what we saw on the screen of the film. Then, of course, there was that incredible David's Drawings book, which compiled all the art and then some, which, in a way, is like having a little piece of the lab within the comfort of your own home. Kinda nice. While the Advent short was a lot more obscured and glitchy in its style, Last Signs of Life gives a slightly clearer, slightly more straightforward look at the set and the props. It does a pretty good job recreating not only this set, but the general atmosphere of the film. We hear the score by Jed Curzel, which I've always thought was pretty top-notch, very creepy and really gets the pulse going. John Denver's Take Me Home Country Roads also appears on the soundtrack briefly, as well as the song Nature Boy by Aurora, which was featured in Covenant's trailer. So there were some very nice touches in this commemoration. Pretty good job. And watching this, honestly, I can't help but get a little sentimental for old Alien Covenant. I like the movie. I still do. I fully understand and appreciate the criticisms, but I liked how gothic and gruesome it was, especially with David's experiments following in the footsteps of the engineers. It's clear to me from Advent and the LV-223 murals that they had gotten their hands dirty with some xenomorph biology long before David, and I think there's potential to explore the ideas presented in Scott's prequels further. But maybe not everyone would agree with me on that, and maybe that's a story for another day. So what I'd like to ask you today is this. Of the short films that accompanied Prometheus and Alien Covenant, do you have a favorite? Is there one that stood out the most to you, or even one you think should have somehow been included in the film? Comment below and let me know. And let's hope we haven't seen the last signs of life from Alien just yet. As always, I'd like to thank you very much for watching today. I really appreciate it. And if you enjoy this video, please make sure to give it a like. And you can also subscribe for all the latest videos from Alien Theory. A very, very special thanks goes out to Weyland-Yutani executives, M. Yorick, and Lady Anne, part of the Patreon Hive. If you'd like to join the Hive and support the channel, check out my Patreon page for exclusive posts and contests. In the meantime, you can catch up with Alien Theory over social media. Follow @alien_theory on Twitter and @alientheoryyt on Facebook and Instagram for more. And until next time, this is Alien Theory, signing off.